Manmohan Kathari from La Montessori School, Kaleli. Today I'm going to demonstrate a project with you. Its name is Siphon Based Electricity Generator. Now this generator basically has three stages: first stage, second stage, and a third stage. Now in this, at the top of the stage we have a motor which is fitted with a turbine, and the water which is coming from the down will hit the blades and it's going to rotate it. Electricity will be generated and it will be flowing through these wires to this battery. Now let's move from the stage 1 to stage 2. We have a U-shaped tube over here, and that is why it is being called as a siphon based electricity generator. Now I have already taken out the water into it, so if we actually unplug this screw, we can see the motor rotating, and again this is actually generating electricity which is being fed into the battery. The use of siphon is it's actually going to carry water at a more force than what the gravity would have been carrying in case we would have been having this hole at the bottom of this tank. So at this moment we are getting more water pressure. So more water pressure means more electricity will be generated. Now from this stage 2 we are going to put this water into a pressurized container. Now for that we need to unplug this. We need to remove some air which is clogged inside it. As soon as it is done, you can see the water gushing down into this pressurized section. You close this. You can close the valve of this airtight container. Now I have a air pump through which we are going to blow in the air. Now we are not actually sucking the water up like we normally do, but we are putting a pressure on this tank so that it actually pressurizes the water down, so that this tube which is actually at the bottom of this tank will carry the water upwards. Now as soon as we start doing it, a very small pressure is enough to make this water flow up. You can see this water has reached up, and there it is rotating this turbine. So as soon as the turbine is rotated, it's going to generate electricity with the motor which is connected to it, and this is going to be fed into this battery, lead acid battery, with the help of a diode. Now a diode will prevent the backflow of current, so the motors are not going to rotate, but when the motors are rotating it will store the charge, but the back charge won't be given. Now the batteries are charged. Again along with this we have a solar panel also attached, and this solar panel again will generate some electricity during the daytime. It's going to charge the batteries, and this charged battery can be utilized to power these LEDs. You can see these powerful LEDs. Along with that, in case you want to measure the voltage, you can measure it with the help of this voltmeter. Currently the voltage onto this voltmeter is 6.30. So that's all about the project. Thank you.